guys, today's my birthday. I was supposed to be vlogging earlier today, but I don't know, it just didn't work out. But I'm vlogging now, and right now I'm going to TJ Maxx to go get something for my photo shoot tomorrow that's happening with my girlfriends. And then after that, I'm gonna go get my tattoo. If my mom is seeing this, mom, if you're watching this, I'm getting a tattoo. Okay, so we're off on the highway now. We just got done shopping at TJ Maxx. I just needed some clothes for my photo shoot tomorrow. So stay tuned. I might do a vlog, I might not, I don't know. We're on our way to the tattoo artist, which will take about 30 or 40 minutes. And hopefully I make it on time because my appointment is at 6. And yeah, I'm kind of excited but so nervous. Just wish me luck because my pain tolerance is pretty low too. We are 4 minutes away. I almost did this. 4 minutes away. 3 minutes now. I'll see you guys at the salon, I guess. So I just got done with the consultation with my tattoo artist. And so far I was thinking, I'm like, should I do it on this side? But I'm like, I don't know, because I have a birthmark here and it looks kind of weird. But I think we settled on the right side. Okay, my cameraman just cut me off. So now my tattoo artist, he's just finalizing the tattoo. So yeah, so this was just like a pin, kind of rough draft. You guys will see the process later if I get the permission, if I can film or not. So yeah, stay tuned.
No, maybe it's just me.
Are you Hmong?
Huh? Yeah.
Even better.
Oh. Yeah, so you actually should be. Let me do a little really easy.
Okay.
Not too bad, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's not like. Amazing, but it's not it's not like soul crushing, right?
Oh, that hurts.
Yeah, this one's a little bit more sensitive because it's closer to the wrist, but there's not much left, so hang on tight and you're done.
Okay, so fast forward to like about 8 days after my last vlog and the day when I was at the tattoo salon or whatever, the tattoo shop. I guess that just explained the process and everything that I went through when I was getting my tattoo. So let me just show you my... So it does say faith if you didn't know that, and there's also like a cross kind of design going on. I think I'm gonna have him like connect the lines right here with the lettering and the line right here, and also with this side. So yeah, so that's how it looks. So I have been wanting a tattoo for a very long time. Maybe like when I was like 16 or 15, but you know, like I was a little too young during that time, so I couldn't get one yet until when it was just my birthday last week on Friday, October 11th. I decided that I was like, why don't I just get a tattoo? I feel like I deserved it. I've gone through so much, and I was like, you know what, Adora, you deserve a freaking tattoo, okay? You've been waiting for this moment for such a long time. But also, I was like a little iffy on getting it because my mom, she's always said no when I ask her if I can get a tattoo. But recently, or the last time that I asked her, which was probably like a month and a half ago, I think, I was like, can I get a tattoo, mom? And then she was like, okay, well, as long as I'm not paying for it. And I'm like, okay. So I took that as a freaking yes. And then bam, y'all girl got a tattoo. But yeah, so that's kind of like a short story that I wanted to tell you. I don't know, a few of my family members, they aren't happy about it, but they'll get over it. So yeah, the reason why I got this tattoo specifically saying faith is because I've been going through a lot this year, like I said, and I just thought that I really needed to reconnect my faith with God. I am a Christian, but I feel like I don't really fit into that label yet because it's been a very interesting journey. I have been growing up in a Christian household, but you know, like as I grew older, I kind of lost my faith with God. And so just this year, I just wanted to pursue God. And with that, I've been trying to go back to church as much as I can, and to also get involved with some programs that talks about faith or like the Bible or like God and all that, you know, at school and stuff. So so far it's going okay, but I really think that I should get more involved as much as possible. So yeah, and I guess that's kind of the reason why I got the word faith, because this year I'm really trying to reconnect my faith with God, like I said, like 20 million times. But yeah, so yeah, that's why I got a tattoo that says faith, and that it also has a cross design onto it. Oh, this tattoo was also kind of inspired by this photo that I found on Pinterest, but I realized that and noticed that a lot of people had that same exact tattoo, so I was like, I'll put up a photo right here. A lot of people do have this tattoo, and I was like, let me try to like tweak it a little bit. Let me see if this tattoo artist of mine can just like tweak it. And so that's what we did. And then we came up with this. Sorry, my skin is still kind of dry from the needling, so please don't mind that. Let's talk about the pain. Okay, so I was so freaking nervous. I was like, oh my God, this is gonna hurt. Like, what makes me think that I can take this pain from this little needle when I can't even handle when someone slaps me in the arm or slaps me somewhere, you know, like on accident or something, or when something freaking hits me and I'm like almost on the verge of crying because my pain tolerance is just so freaking low. I'm just a freaking baby when it comes to pain. Okay, so let me just say the pain was like about a 6.8 on a scale from 10, which I think it's kind of okay. It wasn't that bad, but it did hurt to the point where I was like, ugh. Like, I was just like, I couldn't hold in my pain, you know? So yeah, the way I would describe this pain is kind of like a cat scratching you with like the really sharp claw for like about, I don't know, 10 seconds, because that's how long the tattoo artist kind of like draws into. So but overall, I think the pain was bearable. It was very painful, but it was bearable, and if I can do it, you can do it, like, definitely. So yeah, I'm not really sure what else to say. Oh, so I guess I should also tell you guys how I'm feeling about this. So far I still love it, thank God. I hope to love it until the day I die. But yeah, so far I really love it, and right now it's, like I said, it is kind of crusty, so I try to put lotion on it as much as I can. or when I can. What else? Oh, and the place that I went to was Tough Luck Tattoo. It is located here in Minnesota. It's like a little bit further up north from Minneapolis. I'll just put the location down below. And the tattoo artist that did my tattoo, his name is JTC Tattoos, aka John. He is a Hmong tattoo artist too, so that's pretty cool that I set an appointment up with John. I didn't really know him. I didn't know that he was Hmong. At first, my first impression when I went to the salon, I was like, oh, I'm assuming he's white. I don't know. I don't know why. I just feel like there's not a lot of Hmong tattoo artists here in Minnesota. So I was like, automatically, I thought that the tattoo artist was white. So yeah. But yeah, when I saw him, I was like, oh my God, this is awesome. Like, he's Hmong. When I saw him, I was like, oh, he's Asian. That's cool. But then I didn't know if he was like specifically Hmong. So yeah, when I asked him if he was Hmong, he was like, yeah, I'm Hmong. I was like, bet. From there, I just felt a little bit more comfortable. But that's just me, you know. I'm pretty sure everyone's gonna ask me how much it was. It was like $100. I tipped him about $10 or $15, I think. Because, you know, he was just all nice. So yeah, the price for me, I thought it was like pretty decent. It wasn't that expensive for the tattoo that I got. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else that I need to say other than what I had to do in the process. So I had to wait for about 3 or 4 days. So he gave me this adhesive sticker or whatever that was like stuck onto my skin to kind of like protect my tattoo for a few days, and then he said that I couldn't take it off until like 3 or 4 days later. So I was like, okay. But it was starting to peel off after like the second day, and I was like, oh my God, it's getting like so bad. So I was like, okay, the third day, that's when I just took it off. I was like, and then yeah, I love it. So yeah, I think I'm talking too much, and I think I've covered up everything that I needed to say. So I'm just gonna end it here. Thank you guys so much for watching, if you guys made it till this far. I would really recommend John. He is actually such a cool person, and I love his artwork. It's like totally my style, and it's like very aesthetic, and I'm like, I found my tattoo artist for the rest of my life. So yeah. So if you guys are thinking about getting a tattoo, please hit John up. He is awesome and just very talented. I'm definitely gonna go back to him when I want another tattoo, when I feel like it's time for another tattoo. So yeah, please don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and also comment down below, how's your weekend going, or how's school going, because school has started like about a month or like almost 2 months now. So please leave a comment down below, how's school for you, and I guess I'll see you guys on my next video. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. 305 Highway. Love it.